Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make dimensions in SketchUp. All right, so in a previous video, I made this little camera in SketchUp, and we got to a point where we didn't know the size of this guy because it's not listed here. So I thought for that video, I wanted to redo this so that it is more closely linked to what the actual thing is and add in that dimension. And when I started doing it, I figured, hey, I haven't made a video ever on how to put dimensions in SketchUp, so maybe this is a good opportunity to do that. So in your large toolbar, so if you click over here, if you don't have this guy, you just want to right-click in a white space, and you'll see something called Large Toolset. And then on here, there is this little dimension. And then what you do here is you just select two points and then go in the direction that you want. So we want to go in the red direction here. I don't actually want that dimension, so let's stick with this. So we're going to make this 10 centimeters and then put this here. And it just automatically snaps there. So one thing to know about the dimensions tool is that you can set it. There's a bunch of different parameters that you can set. Currently, this is set so that the text will always face the camera. So no matter where I go, I will be able to see that text pretty clearly. If you click this and you have your default tray open and entity info drop down, you can see that there is align to screen, which is the option we just had. There's also align to dimension. So you may want that for whatever reason, but just know if you have something like this, you won't be able to read that, where you can still read these other dimensions. So, and then there's obviously you can change the endpoints to dots or arrows or closed arrows. So there's some different options in here. I personally like the slashes, just what I'm used to. And then there's also this where you can change the font and the size and the boldness. But so if we change this, I have a font called Flux Architect, which is kind of like an architect style font. It looks like some hand lettering, which I really like. But you'll notice if I come into the dimension and I make a new dimension, it does not have those properties of the text here. So if you want to change the style of your text for all of the dimensions that you make, what you need to do is come to Window, go to Model Preferences, and then at the bottom here, or actually in the middle, there's something called Dimensions. And you can change the endpoints here if you want that to be something. There's also fonts. So if you select fonts, I can go down to, I can hit F, it'll find Flux Architect. I can change it to bold if I want, but I'm just gonna stick with regular for now. Hit OK, and then close out of this. Now you can see I'm gonna delete that guy. Go back to my dimensions, and you can see now I have Flux Architect selected. So what I'm going to do here is just go through and add the dimensions, the standard dimensions, and then we'll go through that really quickly just so you can see a visual process of what I'm doing, and then we'll talk about radiuses. One thing that I really quickly want to say here is that what I'm thinking about here is that I want this to be legible from a particular view. So what I would recommend is finding the view that is most helpful, that gives the most information and a clear view of what you're doing. And then you want to save a scene. So right now in the default flyout, I'm just going to hit this plus arrow and then it gives you this scene. And then you can move around and then just check if the scene works. If you want to get off that, or if you want to turn off that animation, what you can do is go to animation and then disable scene transitions. And that way, when you go back, you won't have to sit through that little animation. Just a little quick tip for you guys. Another thing that I want to mention here is that it's really hard to get a height of circles. So what I've found is that if you turn hidden geometry on, you'll then get these edges. And then when you choose your dimension, you can just select the line there. In this particular case, this is a group. So what I'm going to do is explode it, or you can go into that group if you prefer. And then it'll let you select this line. And you can get the height on that, and then you can just turn hinge geometry off. Okay, so we have all of our dimensions set, and now we need to put in the diameters here and the angle. As I said in the previous video that I did on this, diameters are typically used for full circles, and then radiuses are typically used for partial circles, so something that is curved. And not an entire circle. So what we're going to do here is put in a dimension. And when I choose a circle, it'll automatically put in it says dia 20 centimeters. The same thing on this one. And then you just sort of select where you want to put that text. If I come into this and you right click on that dimension, there's type. You can change it to radius or diameter. I actually have a little key bound in, it's like a little short key that gives me the diameter symbol. So if I type in .dia, it gives me this little symbol here. Really cool program that I use to do that, because I use it for lots of things. It just autofills text. It's called Phase Express. I pay for it, but I think there may be a free version available. So those are two things. And now the last thing that we need to put in is the angle. Okay, so I thought that it would be really easy to put in an angular dimension here, but actually that's not an option in SketchUp. There is a plugin that I'm reading about called Angular Dimension that you can use to get that. But you also, if you're doing this, you don't necessarily need to put in an angle, because you can always use dimensions. So I'm just going to dimension that to 10 centimeters, because that gives the same impression that that's 45. Since this is 10, if that's over another 10, that's a 45 degree angle. So there you go. And then we can just export this. Let me just choose my scene. We'll zoom out a teeny tiny bit. Obviously, if you choose zoom here, I can change the degree. So if we change it to 40, it's a little wider. If we change it to 10, it becomes more flat. And you can obviously go, if I type 1 degree, it becomes very flat. So hopefully you guys thought this video was helpful. If you liked it, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.